exploring the downtown of Bhutan. Before exploring the downtown of Bhutan, let's get some information about the name of the place. The Bhutan was named after Sir Douglas Hooton, who was an American geologist and a physician. Bhutan is also known as one of the best towns from the 100 best towns in USA. And Bhutan is also housed to Michigan Technological University, in which I am completing my master's. So let's start exploring the downtown of Bhutan in this video. So along with tourist places, Bhutan downtown also has various cafes and restaurants where you can chill. So if you want to take some refreshments or some coffee, then there's Big B Coffee. Just when you enter the Bhutan, then you will notice this restaurant. Along with Big B, you can also see the subway. So behind me is the post office of Bhutan. From here you can send mails all over the US and also out of US. This post office also acts as, I think, a passport office, because they have written on the walls to get a passport. If you want to get a passport, you can apply from here. So behind me you can see the Portage Lake Lift Bridge. This bridge is used to connect Hancock and Hooton, the cities which are located on either sides of the Portage Lake. Now I am standing in Hooton and Hancock is on the opposite side of the bridge. This is called a lift bridge because the middle section of the bridge is lifted up when a boat has to pass through it. This bridge is known as the world's heaviest lift bridge. To enjoy the view of the Portage Lake and the lift bridge, there is a small park built over the banks of the Portage Lake, which is known as Bridgeview Park, as you can see behind. So you can sit here and enjoy the view. As you can see behind me, a binocular is also placed here. It is free for all the public, so that they can see the far off places easily. The trail that you are seeing behind me is the Hooton Waterfront Park. It stretches all over the Hooton city, right from the lift bridge and further down till our university. I think it's approximately 2 to 3 miles stretch, which goes alongside the banks of Portage Lake. Now we are heading towards the Portage Lake Bridge. This is our first time on it. Standing on the Portage Lake Lift Bridge, and as you can see behind me is the Portage Lake, and the section which lifts up is just behind me. So this is the section that lifts up, and I will just show you the joint from where it lifts. So as you can see, we can see clearly the water under the bridge, and this is the section from where it gets lifted. So all the section, I think the same type of section will be on the opposite side, and this whole section gets lifted when a boat has to pass under it. So now I'm on the opposite side of the bridge, that is, I'm now in Hancock, and behind me is Hancock. So this is the bridge and I've just crossed it. Houghton is also known as the birthplace of professional hockey. A plaque saying this is placed just opposite the Portage Lift Bridge. Just across the Portage Lake Lift Bridge, there is a Veterans Park, which is a memorial to the Houghton Company which fought in the Civil War. If you are willing to splurge a bit, then there are a variety of restaurants, such as this is Downtowner behind me, and one is the Ambassador restaurant, where you can have dinner or lunch. For some shopping, you can visit Surplus Outlet. Otherwise, you have multiple stores. So now I'm heading home. We have seen most of the places in downtown Houghton, but we are left with two places, that is, one is the Carnage Museum and another is the Hockey Museum, which is also known as the D Stadium. So I will try to cover these two places in the next video. And it's 8:30 in the evening and you can see the sun behind me. It's so bright till late. Generally in summer in USA, the sunset happens at 9 to 10, in between 9 to 10. So I will see you in the next video. Till then, stay safe, have fun.